We are standing by here at St. Leonard's Ministries. This is the halfway house where Weger will now live, just a couple of blocks from the United Center. We're told his first stop after being released this morning was at McDonald's to eat. He was picked up by his sister and her family and was supposed to reunite with his children here in the Chicago area before making his way here to the halfway house. But he did have a chance to speak briefly with reporters before he left downstate this morning.
It's so wonderful just to be able to be out and be my friends and my relatives. I want to thank them for everything they've done for me. I appreciate everything that everybody's done for me to try to get me out of here.
Chester Weger has spent nearly six decades behind bars, convicted in 1961 of the murder of 50-year-old Lillian Oding. Oding's remains were found along with the bodies of two of her friends, Frances Murphy and Mildred Lyquist, at Starved Rock State Park. The women, all from Riverside, were hiking together and found bound, partially nude, and bludgeoned to death. At the time, Weger was a dishwasher at the Starved Rock Lodge. He had initially confessed to killing all three women, but then recanted and has long claimed he is innocent. Prosecutors chose to only try Weger for Oding's murder after he was sentenced to life in prison. Family of the victims have spoken out against his release, but supporters say that Weger poses no threat to public safety. Now, this was his 24th parole request that was finally granted. He will be staying here at St. Leonard's Ministry. We don't know for how long. His attorney says that has not been specified, but that he cannot enter any state parks or return to LaSalle County. We are still standing by here, and when he arrives, we will try to get some more words from him and bring you that live.